Hello everyone, and welcome at a new episode in today's analysis. Today we're going to analyze the director, the main antagonist of Nimona. As I've analyzed my previous video, Nimona herself, it's obviously fitting they will analyze also the main antagonist. From an elitist official that one desires to better her kingdom through very horrible and extremist ways, the director is the perfect representation of a real-life official that abuse their power for their own benefit at the expense of the people. In this video, we're going to analyze all the information given about the director from both the 2015 book and the 2023 film with the same name, and analyze her journey from a simple official to the full-blown traitor and coward that she has ultimately become. Now, with no further introduction, let's dive in. Much about the director's early life and childhood, and even her real name, are largely unknown, except for the fact that she was a kid, she had the same nightmare every night. The wall being cracked open, and the monsters from outside coming into the kingdom, implying that she must have developed some sort of fear for the outside world, and I mean the outside of her own kingdom. Nevertheless, she managed to finish her studies and rose to the ranks until she became the director of the Institute for Elite Knights, founded by Glorette 1000 years prior, and making her the second strongest person in the kingdom, only behind Queen Valerine herself. However, she came at odds with the queen, as while the queen was more liberal and wanted for the commoners to become knights, the director was more traditional and was against this idea, as she believed that commoners becoming knights might make their army to be more weaker and more unable to defend the kingdom against the monsters outside. Nevertheless, the queen rejected her ideas and went with her liberal ones instead. The director must have felt betrayed by the queen at this moment, and thus she came with a plan to kill the queen and frame it on a commoner in order to prove that commoners should not become knights. And so she did. As Queen Valerine was killed, the director put the blame on Ballister Bolthart by making to appear like he killed the queen. After all, she started a kingdom-wide hunting for Ballister, making him the most feared person since Glorette's monster, and making herself the de facto ruler of the kingdom, basically making herself into some nothing short of a dictator. However, her plans are ruined when Nimona, Glorette's master, appears and offers help to Ballister in order to prove his innocence. Ballister discovers that it was the director who set him up. Then he has Nimona to shapeshift into Ambrosius and make her to confess killing the queen and framing him, when the real Ballister recorded everything and put a video on the internet, making the entire kingdom aware what the director has done. However, as the kingdom realized that she is the villain, the director found a way in order to put herself out of this situation, exposing Nimona on TV as Glorette's monster, and causing a rift between Ballister and Nimona, thus resulting in Nimona being turned into the great black beast from the legend. Now, at this point, we can ask ourselves, is the director evil? Well, she might seem like some sort of a well-intentioned extremist who does everything necessary in order to protect her kingdom, yet the fact that you are capable to kill your own superior and frame an innocent man for it, in order to portray her for yourself a good image, is nothing short of absolutely evil. Now, it could be argued that the director might also have some sort of a savior complex for the fact that she believes herself to be the only one who can save the kingdom. Yet, nevertheless, in the end, she wanted to use the cannons to kill Nimona after she shapeshifted back from the big black beast form, and risking to kill half of the kingdom as well, making herself the very evil that she thought she is saving her kingdom from. So in the end, the answer to the question, is the director evil, is definitely yes, as she meets her own undoing at the hand of Nimona, who sacrifices herself in order to save the kingdom from her, ending the director's short-lived reign of terror once and for all. So in the end, who was the director? She was nothing more but an elitist official who desired what's best for her nation. However, one who took horrible extreme measures in order to accomplish this task. One that will make herself the very evil that the kingdom actually can try to protect itself from. And one monster that will be nothing short of pure evil. Thank you all for playing this new episode in today's analysis. I hope you all guys enjoyed. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, ring the bell down below, and put your comments into the sections. And give a like, and have a nice day. Go back to the shadows from whence you came.